All right, everyone, get ready to laugh because I'm about to show you the most absurd board game ever made. Yes, this is Trump the Game. It's made by Parker Brothers, and this is actually a second edition that came out in 2004. The original came out in 1989, which was a mere 3 years after I was born, which means that Trump the Game, yes, is 23 years old. I don't even know where to start with this stupid thing. I guess the best place to start is probably this ridiculous tagline, "I'm back and you're fired." It's so egotistical. I have to love it a little bit. Just everything about this game is Trump. It is Trump to the Trump power times Trump squared. It's so self-indulgent and self-righteous and arrogant and cocky and stupid. It's Donald Trump in board game form. Probably the most noticeable thing about this game isn't even the gameplay. It's the complete lack of quality in the components. Everything feels so cheap and poorly made. Barring maybe the dice and the cards that you get in here, everything just feels like it's gonna break, which is just wonderful in a completely ironic way. So, you might be asking yourself, where did you get this stupid thing? And the answer to that is I bought it at a board game auction a little while back, and I paid a whole $3 for it. Now you're completely justified in asking the next question, which is probably, why would you buy something like this? And the only thing I can say is because I thought it would be funny. And so far, my hypothesis, 100% correct. So what do you do in Trump the Game? Well, you go around the board, which, no surprise, is shaped like a Donald Trump conference slash coffee table. And you can put money into these properties, and they come with these cards and these little black boxes. And basically, nobody knows exactly how much is in here unless you're counting all the money that goes into one of these things. And at the end of the game, if you own this property, you get all the money inside, and whoever has the most money wins. And it's a kind of neat idea, but again, the quality of these things is just terrible. And of course, this being a Donald Trump game, pretty much everything in the box is Donald Trump themed. There's even a card in the game called the Donald, which helps you negate the effect of the You're Fired card. And it's just hilarious. I mean, even the playing pieces are little T's for Trump. Hell, even one of the dice has a T on it instead of a 6. Although, hilariously, in the book it mentions rolling 2 T's. And I don't know if that's a misprint or if I got a mispackage, because only one of my dice has a T on it. But probably the funniest thing in this box is the money, because no surprise, it's Trump money. And even less of a surprise is that it's all in millions of dollars. The smallest bill is 10 million. And you know how there's always that one guy who thinks it's really funny and really cool and really edgy to go to 7-Eleven and try and buy stuff with Monopoly money? I think I can one-up him with a $100 million Trump bill. So that's Trump the Game. It's egotistical, it's arrogant, it's self-centered, it's ugly, and it's just a complete piece of junk. But I will never ever be able to get rid of it. Not just because I'll never make a profit on it, but because this will forever be the funniest thing in my collection. Even if I never get to play this game, it will always be the funniest thing on my shelf. And you know what? For all my harping about how terrible everything is about it, I really do love this game while simultaneously hating every single little thing about it and also hating myself for spending $3 on it.